Welcome back, trainers, and Niantic is just rolling out event after event after event. So what we're going to be taking a look at is the newly announced Incense Day featuring Mareep. So Mega Ampharos has just been introduced. We've been making a ton of videos on it. Really happy with my XL, having fun with it. Looks fantastic as a shiny, and it just looks great as a Mega altogether. So Incense Day, we've seen these before. We're actually going to have different hours, and we're going to see types kind of fluctuating. It's going to be focusing on Electric and Dragon, and that is going to be the typing that Mega Ampharos is going to be picking up, that Dragon typing. So this is going to be going down Sunday, January 24th at 11 a.m. local time until Sunday, January 24th, the same day. It's going to be a several hour event till 5 p.m. local time. All right, so let's take a look at the features here. If you evolve a Phanpy during this time period, you're going to be able to get an Ampharos that knows Dragon Pulse. Okay, we'll talk about that here in just a moment. That is going to be its past Community Day move. And then you're going to be able to purchase yourself a one Pokecoin bundle that is going to have three incense, each one lasting an hour. So that's going to be 3 hours for you. Pretty nice for one Pokecoin. Now let's talk about the exclusive move Dragon Pulse. Is it going to do anything for Mega Ampharos? Well, you're going to be getting Stab, but here is the downside about it, is the fact that Mega Ampharos, or Ampharos in general, just simply does not have a Dragon Quick move. Therefore, it's just not going to be too great as a Dragon type attacker. Now taking a look at the spawns here, Mareep is going to be spawning throughout the entire event. And different Pokemon will be attracted to incense depending upon the hour. And we will be looking at all those spawns here. So from 11 a.m. until 1 p.m. electric type Pokemon. From 1 p.m. until 2 p.m. And this is all going to be local time. Dragon type Pokemon and Pokemon that evolve into Dragon type Pokemon. All right. Very interesting. So things like Horsea and whatnot. From 2 p.m. until 4 p.m. electric type Pokemon yet again. And then from 4 p.m. to 5 p.m. Dragon type Pokemon. And Pokemon that evolve into Dragon-type Pokemon as well. And then throughout all of this, Mareep are going to be spawning. And of course, Mareep Shiny has been released, so you're going to be able to potentially get one of those Shiny if you're looking for that, or a good IV one. And as we do know, Ampharos is going to actually be pretty decent in the Ultra League and have some play in the Great League as well. So you may want to stack up those candies. Maybe you want to make an XL Ampharos. I personally did that myself yesterday. I don't know. I mean, going up against Kyogre, going up against Mega Gyarados raids, whenever those are going to be released, because Mega Gyarados is going to be water typing. Unfortunately, it is picking up the dark typing, so it's not going to be like some sort of super killer. But nonetheless, there you have the different times here. All right, so taking a look at the electric type spawns that you can expect to see during those hours, you have Pikachu shiny, Magnemite shiny, Voltorb shiny. I personally need that. Chinchino, I also need that shiny. Mareep, Plusle, Minum, and then they do go on to say, if you're lucky, you might encounter a Stunfisk. Not, you might encounter a shiny Stunfisk. You might encounter one, which is leading to they're going to be very rare. Okay, simple as that. So basically, for the electric types here, you're going to be looking for that shiny Chinchino, Voltorb, potentially Magnemite. If you need Plusle and Minum, Mareep, personally, I did the Community Day when it was around, and I really don't need any more Shinies, including catching some outside. We'll be looking for those Stunfisk, and every time I do see one, I will be giving it a Pineapp and Silver Pineapp so I can get as many XL and candies possible for the Dragon spawn. So let's get it. Here we go. We have Horsea Shiny, Dratini Shiny, Mareep, Trapinch and its evolution, Swablu, and Bagon. Let's go with the Bagon. You know me and my Shadow Shiny Salamence that I have been talking about. So you want to get as many Dratini, I want to say Swablu, and Bagon candies as possible. All of them, to be honest with you, but you want to hyper-focus on those. Personally, maybe even Dratini's, and then Swablu, Bagon as well, like I just said. Because, well, if you have a Shadow Dragonite, those things are going to be absolutely amazing. Regular Dragonites are performing fantastic anyways. Swablu, maybe you need some candies, and we will be getting that Mega down the line, so you maybe want to start stacking those for that Dragon and Fairy type. We're actually going to go over that as well. And then Bagon's shiny Shadow that I do have, well, the Shadow is going to just be outperforming the Mega Salamence, simple as that. It's pretty crazy, so I am going to be working on those candies and stacking those up and investing in that XL. Now, taking a look at all the Dragon typings, just for reference here, you have Mega Rayquaza, which is not even available yet, with Dragon Tail and Outrage. Then you have Shadow Salamence with Dragon Tail and Outrage, Mega Garchomp, not available. Shadow Salamence with Draco Meteor and Dragon Tail, Shadow Dragonite, Shadow Dragonite again, but with Draco Meteor, it's Community Day move. Shadow Dragonite with Outrage. Black Kyurem, which is not even in the game. Shadow Dragonite again, and then Mega Salamence finally making an appearance at the bottom there. But it's not all doom and gloom for it, because if you take a look at the DPS times TDO, that's basically how much damage they're going to be doing, as well as survivability. It is only going to be number 3 compared to Mega Rayquaza and Mega Garchomp. Otherwise, it's going to be outperforming everything else. So just because it is at the bottom doesn't mean it's going to be horrible. But nonetheless, at the end of the day, Shadow Salamence is just putting in that work. So I'm going to be hyper-focusing on those and using as much Silver Pineapple Berries and regular Pineapple Berries as possible to stack those candies. As far as Mega Altaria, I mean, it's not going to be like top Dragon-type attacker whatsoever. It's quite unfortunate because it is going to be a PvP-style Pokemon, but we have no confirmation as to how that's going to work. So taking a look at Mega Salamence here, it is going to have a max CP of 4,210, HP 197, Attack 282, and Defense 228. So like we've seen on the list, it is going to have a fantastic DPS times TDO, third to Mega Rayquaza and Mega Garchomp. So what I'm trying to get at is basically, all right, Mega Salamence is not going to even be able to outperform Shadow Salamence. Is it even great? Yeah, it is actually pretty good. So if you do have a good IV one, still focus on that, because this is going to be a fun Pokemon to have and a fantastic raid attacker. We've discussed this before, but the competition is steep with these Shadow Pokemon and these Mega Evolutions like, Rayquaza and Mega Garchomp and things like that. Competition is crazy, and the Shadow Pokemon were a big surprise, and now they're dominating the top of the charts for pretty much everything because they're just that strong. So don't disregard other Pokemon. Looking at Mega Altaria, it is going to have a max CP of 3,163, HP 181, Attack 222, and Defense 218. So it is going to actually be dropping its flying typing and picking up the fairy typing, which is very interesting because fairy does resist dragon. Now in the main series games, fairy just straight up shuts down dragon. It does no damage to it, much like psychic to dark. But in Pokemon Go, you still deal damage. Also, another comparison is ground type moves doing damage to flying type moves. It's just the way it works in Pokemon Go, and ghost type moves doing damage to normal and vice versa. Those things in the main series games just absolutely do no damage to each other. But in Pokemon Go, they do, because, well, it would kind of break the mechanics if you just couldn't do any damage. So Altaria, despite having that fairy typing, will take damage from dragon type moves, obviously, it's a given, but it is going to be resisted. Very interesting, and can't wait to see how it does perform. If you did enjoy this video, please give it a big thumbs up, subscribe if you're new, turn notifications on, and I'll be keeping you up to date on everything Pokemon Go and bringing you some more Go Battle League battles, and I have some very interesting ones. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you all next time. Take care.